said it now. That is what's going on. Don't resist. I mean, who am I talking to? I'm talking to no one. This is my ghost here. This is my friend. You are just a flat shield. You don't even exist. Time is different over there where you are looking at it now. Listen. Can you just objectively analyze what I just said? And that this is going on in all your 6 million voices. 6 billion voices. Now, could you just pass on the fucking moving? Have someone watch it? And if someone understands it, that it tells the moron that doesn't want to watch it or is not interested in it to pass it on anyway. That's the objective here. You are not the object of fame. I do not need you. I have more important things to do and to consider. Just get it somewhere. That's it. Do you understand now? This 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours even, how long? That's it. Get these things, it's all in the fucking diagrams, culture and everything. You don't just sit there and then, you know, next fashion. You can't. The only thing that you can't do is that this again is fashion. You got a guy and he's saying things and you sell it for 60,000 euros or something. You know, 60 billion, whatever, Van Gogh. It's a sale. It's an artwork. But this is not an artwork, an expendable thing. This is not a fashion. Art is not a fashion. This guy, you know, he was aware of the decaying landscape of Holland and the artisan life. After that, if Van Gogh lived to an extent, you actually bully farmers out of your villages. Because you want to live in an IKEA house of matrix, and there is an actual farmer there with chickens in Holland. I saw the documentary. You bully him the fuck out. And then you say, I don't have a job, I am unemployed. Now where's my chicken? Yeah, I got fries and hamburgers. Where is it? No, they need bistros and quality food, right? The chicken bros at the other side of the road. And Van Gogh, you pay 60 billion, you would be aware that he's actually standing there. Jesus Christ, this evolution, something is missing. And he's thinking, and he's painting. There's melancholy in it. There's not technology in it. And still, if you balance it all out, realism, technology, industrialism, futurism, take a comparison. They're all having a certain trouble and trying to solve something. If you cannot do that, if you just analyze, stop doing that then. And just, yeah, then serve me. Kneel for me. Here's the fucking sword. I give you the sword, then you put the sword on my feet. What is your problem? Then that is, if you're that imbecile, if you're really, really little children or something, and you only actually respond to a fairy tale, then do that. Then you have to do that. I mean, if it's the only way that I can actually convince you of anything. You have invented the serenity or the minimalism of politicians' neckties and sitting there like that professionally, but you screw it up anyway. You have any possible solution to fix it, to have any kind of, but you didn't do it. You fucked it up. What am I supposed to do? You argue too much. You think everything is funny. In a fictional place and in some decadence, you see them wear this thing on their neck, or they wear, but they don't look particularly stupid to me in pictures, not in real life. You have to, I don't know. Some of them already been starting doing it for a picture. I don't know. It's a fashion at that point. How are you going to actually have any fashion last for? And an entire aesthetic world like Paris at some point or whatever, the neoclassics, I don't know. and how it can be serious, how it can also have architecture. I have no idea how you can have gardens and actually have use to that. I have no fucking idea. Now, how are you going to stop laughing? I don't have a fucking clue. I evaluate insensitivity or you know, there's things that make me look like a fool right now. Seriously. But this is not my world that I see. And I am caught in it. It is like a panopticon. I can see all you laughing. I don't know where to get to suicidal or something. I'm trying very hard. That's why I look. It's 15,000 profiles. It's just not valuable to me to have these. I want the misery. If not, I will make these 15,000 who have not any sort of decency, I will make you misery, and you will be misery at some point. To deny me, to walk away, or anything that you do, you will be misery by my cause, and that will be my honor. That is, you are so fucking miserable, God, honor, but it's true, if I do that to you, oh, honestly, I am going to enjoy that again. I have been nothing but writing a letter for some. I've been randomly, but no, nothing of you. And I have to challenge so many idiots, and I have to see all these fucking smiles, panopticon of all laughing at me. Because who are you laughing at anyway? You're laughing at the world, you're also laughing at me, because you know, I would like to do things. But all your laughter and all your debates and analysis, and I cannot get through anywhere. And all I see is this enjoyment. Then you have the commercials. Luckily, I can actually get tapes of movies without fucking, you know, movies with designs and everything. And worlds I would actually consider, you know, in architecture, not in the life. I mean, you people mix it up. Now, at what point do you think that you do not have to help me if you come here? Oh no, I don't want to do that. Oh no, what can I do? Yeah, that's the ones that I find here, the ones that I find there. Oh no, I'm in existentialism. At what point do you think that in all this fucking babble and laughter, you do not have to help me? This is not normal to me. I crafted the sculpture for this fucking suburban thing, and then what do you think? Money? That is art to me. This is not absolutely art to me. I don't have any fucking point to build this, but I would just give you the skin. You want the skin stand there. This is my reality, but I don't have anything to do in your reality. You cannot resist. Helping me to get anywhere to people who actually just walk around and create and observe. You have no right to not help me. This is not your right. I mean, I cannot actually help each and one of you and then get pissed off or you wonder why you're doing that for me. I cannot do that for you 700 people that I don't know this. Maybe it blocks, I don't know. I try to talk to you, but it ends at some point. You have to give me credit, and you know, but listen, I'm not going to be. If I just die, and you all still keep laughing, and then you're seriously going to laugh. But I don't care. And if you do, I mean, you don't know what you're going to end up in. I mean, I consider the variety, but you know, hysteria of South Park post politicians is. It's a friction, and it's all the what are you gonna think of next? There has to be an answer or a consequence. Something has to exist other than that. And apparently, my mind is sort of like, yeah, we can puzzle it out here and there. And if you're going to just pass along, I can stand in the street and actually see you pass along. But if I talk to you, and then you go on and you watch your own little favorite show, one of 6 billion. Now, at what point are we not making sense? What do you think you really talk about? If you talk to me, I mean, you know, if I'm talking and people just go like, yeah, oh, you're a comedian, no, I'll never work. You would throw him, wow, that would be a bit too much. You can do, oh, there's so much hope in that, but in the end, you know, nobody else, if I say, you know, here's the book, we are wasting time, I say this, we are wasting time, here's the data, here's the book, let's print this out, and then he goes, hey, wait a minute, hey, what am I gonna, then he says, hey, you know that, but not everybody knows that, but, you know, but if I know that, and if it's actually making people hysterical, as he says the whole time, you know, hysteria, that's, then he says, you know, you're Byron, yeah, Byron, they had the locker of him, and of Byron, and, you know, but, you know, you have a point here, right? Well, he said they have a point here, but the point, I don't have a point here. You don't have a point here. No, you have a point to be here. But that point is something that, you know, I mean, if I stand on the street and I see you pass by and you know, I would talk to you, but I mean, there's one near the resurrection of Christ, there's another in this, and another this, and another with I mean, nutcases, and then people, oh, the trees are cut down in our little village, and then you get these people with a questionnaire for a cellular phone or an iPod. Now, at what point do I, you know, I have a point here. Well, at what point can I actually, I mean, where am I supposed to direct myself? If I go to Obama, I get a fucking iPod, and he says, yeah, do a video that one, and this and that, yeah, but there's nothing for you, you're just providing everything to yourself, it's a saturation of the individuals. You have no future, you have no wealth, you have no architecture, you have nothing. You invest the crap to saturate the individuals, all kinds of cheap things, and then you have no future, no progress, no space travel, no expansion of your mass volume, no calculation of your gardens, opposed to no variety in the meadows, that you have weeds, that bees and variety can exist. You fuck up everything. And you have the nerve to say, we are an advanced society, and then you have the nerve to say, as humans, we deserve to die. And, you know, birds are more. And all of this makes no fucking sense at all. People that invented it are wondering about it, and it is a fact that all the consumers that buy it just fling it in the air. That's what you are. I don't want to patronize 6 billion people, but this is a fact. Inventors, they wouldn't just now buy and fling it in the air, talk to my girlfriend and this. You can have some, but this is going too far. Someone has to say it if I do it too. Oh, you should see me treat digital equipment. I can be a hypocrite even, but someone's got to say it, and someone got to actually find. It's true. I mean, you people just did. As ergonomics, it cannot exist. You cannot fling these cellular phones up in the air and then throw it right in the park. This is you can't do that. It sounds very silly, but if you 6 billion, do that. This is going to. But you know, and then you come back with this existentialism. Please, you are devout Christians and you kneel for God. And there's many people do that. And now you all laugh at that. And all you now say, if anyone says, please do this and this and that to get it organized. Then you say, oh, I'm a hedonist, man. I don't give a shit. That stubbornness is yeah, if you're a hedonist, man, then I can slap you in the face for, I give you immortal life, and I can slap you in the face for eternity or something. And eternity, I mean, being slapped in the face, being tied up, being intravenously fed, and being slapped in the face for all eternity. Do you have any idea what your heart would actually come alive at that point? You have got immortality cure, but now you're all going to die. Because, I mean, Jesus, the consequences of this, I don't want to face this decision that you're going to actually say something at this point when you got what the 5 Pandora sciences, as I call them, immortality science, nuclear science, nanotechnology. If you, I take the risk to give all kinds of ideas to restore the entire world, 90%, 50% is already designed, I have to do that for you. And then the question is, who is going to catch, if commercial enterprise is going to catch all these technologies, and what you're going to be doing with that, and what you all lunatics, as lunatics that you these days are, existentialists and hedonists, whatever you think you are, there's going to be lunatics, and I don't know, if I die, this will not be my option, that, you know, you know, it's funny, but it's not, if I die, then it doesn't matter. But you know, you could also wake up, even if you die, being cloned. You get taught your past, you start to believe you're you, and at that point they say, well, here's the real world. An old entire fucking wasteland of guillotines, tortures, people suffering. See? You can do that. With science, this is possible. At what point do you think I, as in my loneliness here, find it interesting to listen to your Obama, and I don't dare to name people now, see? Because, I mean, these politicians of Italy or whatever, at what point do you get scared of the future? And at what point, if you're scared of it, do you actually also take it 5 minutes seriously? At what point are you prepared to waste to get 5 minutes lower than intelligent people, 5 minutes, and have them gather up, you know, just and talk, how are we going to get this straightened out, and these technologies? You need non-greedy people for this, and I hope that I am one non-greedy person, if I succeed, and that there are others like that. If you, I mean, the most hopeful thing is that you're just idiots. There's nothing wrong with that. But to create beauty, I think you will have a few thoughts going all wrong somewhere. And if you create a future, if you start colonizing planets, I imagine you can do that. That it's easier than you do think. No, I mean, put the biosphere on it. You haven't seen it. Your fucking star, your fucking relative this and this fails. You know, you have any idea how many projects in the past failed? Do you have any idea where we got technology-wise? Now, if you get it something done, then you can start to make things relative. It did fail, but first do something. Now, if it starts to get so easy, you have all this desert, now at what point are you actually going to have, you know, like these idiots everywhere screaming around, and these poisonous bitches like and at what time you have no will or no action to go forward, so you're just all nowhere. And at what point this is my decision, because if I propose it, if I create it, then it might actually happen. And I took that, I mean, what else can I do, actually? I can redesign 50% of, I mean, everybody's complaining, you know? This world is shit. And then if I say 50%, we do it like that, and the other 99%, they get that pretty much worked out in the circles and everything. Now, if you consider me to call me a megalomaniac or insane, now, who is fighting who? These are, of course, therapists, because they want patients to be really depressed, because normality rules this fabulous earth. And we will find the solution somewhere. And the insane patients, they can say, no, there was, you see, you're battling each other. I want both of you to stop. Poof! So yeah, I mean, you have to take the decision anyway. Why would you destroy an entire culture of 100 years of Art Nouveau, or biospheres with gardens and birds on Mars and Moon, for the risk that you could be, that you could create eternal hell, torture instruments, that the immortality sign, this, I mean, you can't even, you're not evil enough to do that. This is impossible. I think so, but I believed it, because I looked at you, and sometimes, somewhere I can see that in you. Somehow, yeah, I see that, and so I got these ideas. Where would I get these ideas? In myself, so I'm going to do that myself. I don't get it. I constantly, you're scared of me, then, and you don't want to give me it because you're scared. You think that, you know, this idea that if I now get out get actual people to actually build something, then I'm going to build torture dungeons or something. I don't know, you can constrain me. That's why I ask, actually ask nice people, and even women, nice women, but try to act really considerate. Somehow you wonder if it exists. And develop this properly. But, we have a lot of problems. Where do these images come from? I mean, Jesus Christ. You're insane. You have visions, you have fears. But man, look at this panopticon of fucking smiles and stupidity, and you're sitting there. I'm so relaxed. You're in fear. You would get this pill, and this pill will also help you. That is absurd. And the smiles are also absurd. I mean, that image, if you see it on the screen, you see, I should come in. Everybody's scared of a camera, what they're doing in the real world. And up on the camera, then they start shining and glowing of dreams. That is how it works. It's amazing. I don't even know what to know, what the actual reality is underneath. I mean, why don't you film everything that they say in the White House, in the server? What is it actually going on there? How is the atmosphere? I don't know, I want to understand that. So, or at the NASA or whatever, why don't you just put cams everywhere? I mean, you see the smiles of frivolous amusement on everything going wrong, but why don't you count the actual reality of where everyone is crafting and trying to come up with small ideas? And if you value all those, I mean, I want to do that. I want to value these ideas, but there's, and I also want to see that you develop it, but you don't listen to me. I mean, and it doesn't seem like you could really get it more. You know, if you would listen to me, that you know, this is how it is. I mean, please. I mean, this opinion. You don't have to stick to that opinion. I had so many, but you don't have to stick to the opinion that all there is to this world is 10,000 corpses in fucking. In this time, that you know, you find the last corpse and then you'll die and mankind is extinct. Everybody says a variation of that, and you know, now I am very unhappy to have to show my face on a camera. If I had a nice life, an ordinary life, if I had like that much of a woman, like some women exist, I don't know. Well, then no, I mean, it's still do. I mean, I don't lose my intelligence at that point. So I'd still do it, but you know, but sort of for now, I mean, it is normal that I am angry because everyone flipped. Like, oh man, you just bullshit me. I don't take it, and that's why I get no kinds of problem and you kick me out, but you bullshit me. You are not talking to me. These, not these women, not these sad things, and not these, nothing, no one does. Even younger girls, I think they're more interested in all other ideas, but you're chickens. As soon as I would even adopt a 16-year-old here, I think your brain nerving for the actual the life that you actually led in the vulgarity of modern life, you're actually going to just do that again. This is disgusting. I don't want that. Now get me to someone who just walks on this earth freely and isn't adopted in the religion of this stupid life. Bring me something, someone like that. I don't have I don't have indiscretion to actually. This seems normal. Not as a woman or, you know, to get married or anything like that. This is a completely different concept. No, really. This is like this is I don't know. I mean, getting a girlfriend, that's what I'm gonna, no, seriously, you something strange about the atmosphere here. I mean, there's no... I don't know, somehow... you can see in everything here that there's something wrong. That someone does not cooperate as such. Seriously, that you have made a mistake to not give me 5 minutes more of the appropriate interest outside of your regular duties, like, you know, some therapists even say, you know, I give you an entire formula, a theory about the expansion of culture, and you think, now, where am I going to give it? That politician, that politician, that politician. I give it to the mayor. Here he says, here, go to the, well, I didn't give it. I give him an actual mythology. I thought, you know, mythology about this. Well, you go to the you know, brotherly, the fair, the fair, the folklore fair too. You know, stuff. But it's not the fame, or, I mean, you either find the elite, or you find the fame, or you find, but the standard of folklore, these people, I cannot talk to them. The minority needs to get famous, the majority can have another's fame built, but it's very funny, you see? That's very funny, that's strange, but you need to do that anyway. That's how you're going to have to do it. You have to get to court where people can go. I mean, you know, if you have any court in the past, any time in the past, there was some notion, you know, that's where an artist needs to be. And at this point, there is no such center to anything. That's why, you know, that's why this whole movie is made.